gotta ask him if this is the right one. You know, God's always right. Appreciate Brother Jordan right there. Keep going. Virgil, I think a little bit of practice with the boys, if you'd be up there just saying that before then. Amen. Thank you, brother. That works. Stand, if you would, just turn to the book of Exodus. Book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 14. Exodus 20, verse 14. I'm trying to say amen.
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 Exodus 20, verse 14. Everybody got it? Thou shalt not commit adultery. Say it again. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Pretty plain language, isn't it?
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to forgive us sin, tied me behind the cross. That every word I say will be coming through you. Lord, I ask you to be with us this morning as we read a portion of your word, that it would make us, when we leave here, be able to say it was good to be in the house of the Lord. Lord, just be with me as I preach the sermon. It will be done. We thank you and we praise you in your precious name. Amen. Thank you. When God made man, his first command, who gets repeated as well? Sometimes they will have to. When God made man, his first command was to mankind was for them to multiply. Amen. God made man a sexual being. Our sexuality has been corrupted by sin. Amen?
Amen.
Don't hit me out now. God's plan is for the sexual relationship to be between a husband and wife only. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Not man and man or woman and woman. Eyes of God, that's wrong. I don't care what the politicians say, but they're wrong. Genesis 20 verse 9 says, 6 days thou shalt labor and do all the work. Okay? What he's talking about there now, Leviticus, that's what I want to hit on. Leviticus says they both should be put to death. I know that's Old Testament, but the sin hadn't changed. When we think of adultery, we don't have to think of man being unfaithful to his wife, but it works both ways. We have to admit it when we want to enough where sexuality is rampant all over our country. It's on television, Facebook, magazine, billboard. We watched a show this morning, last night, brother. Almost every time your show's on, you're going to sit there watching long enough, you're going to see some gays come on there then. Are we supposed to love them? Yes. We're supposed to hate their sin.
Man.
But you name it, society, sex sells. That's what they want. It seems to be what people like. But there's a few people that stand firm against it. We need to take a stand. We got an election coming up in less than 3 months. Be a politician. I'll be getting them some voter guide before long. Like I did last year. Look it, take it over. Look, see how they voted. Democrat, vote, whatever it is, if they don't vote right, vote against them, amen. We get too hung up on parties. When Jesus was on this earth, he looked at his culture and labeled it. He said, an adulterous and sinful generation. What they said in Mark. Some of you may be thinking, preacher, is this material really relevant today? Yes, it is. My answer would be yes. We live in a world, don't you hear somebody figure it out? We live in a world where nearly 50% of all men say they have committed adultery. And that's And that's just the number that was admitted. Research has been also that nearly two-thirds of all married men were committed adultery. Before the age of 40, 41% of the women say they have committed adultery. Now, do you think it's still relevant for today? World, it is. It is. But what is bad is the figures are just as bad for people who go to church. Amen? Christians today want a random sample with thousands of subscribers, and they questioned them, said 45% had acted inappropriate and said they had committed adultery. No wonder the churches are falling apart, amen? People won't take stand. Come on now, help me out. Don't get mad at me. Help me out.
Amen.
It's relevant because it has a negative effect on our young people. One out of five youth lost their virginity before the age of 13. It's no wonder. No wonder. These kids are watching. Sometimes they watch the parents. It can be traced back to a lack of morality and standards at home. When parents allow their children to bring their boyfriend or girlfriends to live with them, that opens the floodgates, amen? It's okay to do that, they're saying. When children see their parents living an immoral life, it sends a message that sexual immoral is okay. So many parents don't monitor what the kids watch on TV or Facebook. I talked to Ronnie, Holly, Lindsay. Be careful on Facebook. Be careful. Billy Graham said while he was healthy and did a survey, he found that 40% of youth that are in a Bible-believing church were sexually active. He also found that 60% of single adults were not only sexually active, but over half of them had multiple partners. I want to tell you something. Don't you listen. God is still against adultery. Still against it. He hates it. And he'll punish those who continue to do it. When a man and woman get married, they become one flesh. Genesis 2:24. One of them be part of joined together outside of marriage. They've broken that bond. Join another. 1 Corinthians 6:16 says what? Know not that he would join and harlot in one body. But two to sin, he should be flesh. God says a harlot is no different than a prostitute. Adultery destroys the trust of marriages. This is why Jesus gave an escape clause. Let's turn to Matthew. Hold your place. Let's turn to Matthew 19. Matthew 19. Matthew 19, verses 3 through 9. Came to pass after Jesus had finished these sayings, he departed from Galilee, came into the coast of Judea beyond Jordan. Great multitude followed him, and he healed them there. The Pharisees came up to him, tempting, saying unto him, is that lawful for a man to put away his wife for every cause? Verse 4, and he answered and said unto him, have you not read that he that which made him at the beginning made male and female? And for said, this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, they shall cleave together his wife and husband. Marriage must be adultery proof. Adultery is also an attack on one's children. David's children, when he committed sin, followed his own footsteps. Absalom took his father's concubine with himself. Children lose respect for their parents if they're not faithful. Adultery among many believers is a result of being backslidden individual. They're not in touch with the Lord. And once that line is crossed, the enemy will continue to attack it in that area. Doing it the second, third, and fourth time will be hard to avoid. Many people are guilty of adultery, even though they not never to know it as much as a matter of heart. But I say to him, unto you, that whosoever looketh for a woman to lust after her hath already committed adultery. Amen? Come on now. Don't tune me out. Don't tune me out. You know it's the truth, because sometimes the truth hurts. Amen?
Amen.
There'd be a terrible price to pay for crossing that line. Adultery will destroy a witness testimony. People see you doing things you shouldn't do, and you told them you're a Christian. That kills the whole testimony about that. Many TV evangelists have been called to acts of adultery in the ministry of God. When you commit adultery, just try to tell a sinner how they can be saved. The preacher Hagin will be on guard. Psalm 100, verse 3 said, "Know ye that the Lord is God. It is he that has made us, not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture." His people. Just ask David what happens when you lies your eyes wonder. 2 Samuel 11:12. He slept with Bathsheba, then had her husband be sent to the front line to fight, only be killed. We'll guard our eyes, our flesh, our minds. If you put the right stuff in our mind, we won't have this problem. In our world, it's hard to avoid sexual perverts. When this happens, goes the family, goes the church. Satan knows if he can get the family, he's got the church. Every great empire that has fallen has done so as a result of sexual immorality. Is America next to fall? Are they? 1 Corinthians 12:26, and do not think that your sins are private things. The truth is saying adultery and it tarnishes the name of the church and destroys your ministry. Adultery is such a sin against society. One writer said that adultery is an enemy of the state. All reasons for not committing adultery, Joseph was tempted. Joseph. Adultery is considered the great sin. Genesis 20, verse 9. Adultery was punished by death. Leviticus 20, verse 10. Adultery destroyed that which was created be the most visible of God's relationship to his people, marriage. Ephesians 5:22-23. God's prohibition against adultery was not to ruin man's life, it was to protect the home which they lived in. When a person commits adultery, the cause of Christ is hindered, and the name of Jesus is dragged down. Our duty is to be sexually pure as we can. We are to avoid any activity may tempt us to do that. In closing, what can people do to avoid the trap? The five steps, you got to walk with the Lord. Genesis 5:16, this I say, that walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. If people would do this daily, they will have the ammunition they need to fight Satan.